First of all, congratulations on the new album. I heard it. Awesome. You must be proud because I know for you this is really a labor of love.
Thank you. I'm really overwhelmed with the response actually, and it really broke my heart writing it. So the fact that people are kind of taking it to their hearts cheers me up massively.
Broke your heart? Why?
It was just I have to admit things to yourself that you don't really want to know.
So you have to really dig. You're yeah. the type of writer that digs down deep.
Yeah. Right there. Yeah. I'm just quite like I like to think I'm quite fun normally, but when I'm writing songs, the running theme so far seems to be like misery. So I have to kind of channel it, you know, and it's quite depressing for a while. About 9 months before I started making the record, when I first started thinking, oh, maybe in about 6 months I'll go into the studio and have a go at writing a new song or whatever, that bit I found really, really frightening. But by the time I actually got in the studio, I was so excited to be making new music and seeing, like, new musicians and old musicians that I'd worked with and known for ages. I honestly forgot about any pressures that anyone was kind of putting on me or anything like that. Just went with what felt right, which is good because I think people overthink records, especially second records. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm a fan of a lot of people who recently released their second record, and it didn't win me over. I preferred the first record, you know. And I think when you overthink it, you don't deliver because you're frightened of it, you know. And I think if you forget, luckily I did. You know, I think hopefully people will believe me on this record, you know. Hope so.
Music really should come from here.
Yeah.
Really not from here. We
yeah.
get down to it.
Yeah, so hopefully that comes across, because I certainly felt that way. And occasionally I would sort of trip in and out of thinking, like, why aren't I thinking, is this song radio friendly or something? Like, kept thinking maybe I was like a bad artist for not considering those things, but I'm glad I didn't in the end. Well, when I was a teenager, I discovered Etta James, which I think is where most of my, I don't know, styles or something come from, probably. I loved her hair, which was what made me buy the record. It was in like a bargain bin, it was really cheap. It's just a generic record, it wasn't like a specific one. Listened to it and I'd never been so moved by someone's voice, ever. It wasn't much competition, it was the Spice Girls that I was in before that, and you know, they're not known for their vocals, but they're pretty awesome as well. But yeah, Etta James and then Carole King and Roberta Flack and Billie Holiday and Ella Fitzgerald and Peggy Lee and Karen Dalton, and then I got kind of into Tom Waits and stuff like that, so it just kind of escalated from there really. But I don't know, I don't only listen to old music, there's just something about, I find it quite fascinating that, like, you know, I'm in 2011, whatever, and listening to something that was recorded 60 years ago, like, I find that really, like, gives me chills, do you know what I mean? So it's just kind of, I just really enjoy it.